subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
From an ancient mammoth tusk discovered deep under the ocean to bees that have evolved to eat meat. These are some of the stories that we talk about on this episode of Scientifics. I am Mohana Basu, and every week on the Prince Scientifics, I take you through some of the top science stories of the week from across the globe. This week, scientists have discovered a little-known species of tropical bee that evolved an extra tooth for biting flesh and a gut that more closely resembles that of vultures rather than other bees. Typically, bees don't eat meat. However, a species of stingless bee in the tropics have evolved the ability to do so. Scientists presume that this is a result of intense competition for nectar. These are the only bees in the world known to have evolved to use food sources not produced by plants. Honeybees, bumblebees, and stingless bees have guts that are colonized by the same five core microbes. Unlike humans, whose gut microbes can change with diet, most bee species have retained the same bacteria over 80 million years of evolution. Given their radical change in food choice, a team of scientists wondered whether the gut bacteria of vulture bees differ from those of a typical vegetarian bee. On analyzing the microbiomes of the bees, they found the most extreme changes among exclusive meat feeders. The vulture bee microbiome is enriched with acid-loving bacteria, which their vegetarian relatives don't have. But even though they feed on meat, their honey is still sweet and edible. The vulture bees store the meat in special chambers in their hives that are sealed off 2 weeks before they access it, and these chambers are separate from where the honey is stored. The research team is now planning to delve further into vulture bee microbiomes, hoping to learn more about the genomes of all bacteria as well as fungi and viruses in their bodies. Also this week, data from European Space Agency's Gaia mission has revealed that most of the dwarf galaxies in the Milky Way, which have traditionally been thought of as satellites, actually only arrived in our vicinity in the last few billion years. The findings rewrite the history of our galaxy. A dwarf galaxy is a collection of between 1,000 and several billion stars. For decades, it has been widely believed that the dwarf galaxies that surround the Milky Way are satellites, meaning that they are caught in the orbit around the galaxy and have been our constant companions for many billion years. Researchers have now computed the motions of these dwarf galaxies with unprecedented detail. The team found that these galaxies are moving much faster than the giant stars and star clusters that are known to be orbiting the Milky Way. So fast that they couldn't be in the orbit yet around the Milky Way, where interactions with our galaxy and its contents would have sapped their orbital energy and angular momentum. The new study, which represents the majority of the dwarf galaxies around the Milky Way, strongly suggests that the dwarf galaxies have only arrived in the vicinity in the last few billion years. Also this week, researchers suggest that the Arctic Ocean has been getting warmer since the beginning of the 20th century, decades earlier than records suggest. The warming is a result of warmer water flowing into the polar ecosystem from the Atlantic Ocean. An international group of researchers reconstructed the recent history of ocean warming at the gateway of the Arctic Ocean in a region called the Fram Strait between Greenland and Svalbard. Using the chemical signatures found in marine microorganisms, the researchers found that Arctic Ocean began warming rapidly at the beginning of the last century as warmer and saltier waters flowed from the Atlantic. These changes preceded the warming documented by modern instrumental measurements. Since the year 1900, the ocean temperature has risen by approximately 2 degrees Celsius, while sea ice has retreated and salinity has increased. The study provides the first historical perspective on Atlantification of the Arctic Ocean and reveals a connection with the North Atlantic that is much stronger than previously thought. Meanwhile, using seismic data from the second largest volcanic region on Mars, researchers have had the opportunity to get a peek under the layer of the red planet. The team has found the presence of a shallow sedimentary layer sandwiched between lava flows beneath the planet's surface. The team examined this shallow subsurface to around 200 meters in depth. Right beneath the surface, they discovered a layer of sandy material approximately 3 meters thick above a 15-meter layer of coarse rocky blocks that were ejected after a meteorite impact and fell back to the surface. Below these top layers, they identified around 150 meters of basaltic rocks, which are cooled and solidified lava flows. Between these lava flows, starting at a depth of about 30 meters, the team identified an additional layer of 30 to 40 meters thick with low seismic velocity, suggesting it contains weak sedimentary materials relative to the stronger basalt layers. The team suggests that the shallower lava flows are about 1.7 billion years old. In contrast, the deeper layers below the sediments formed much earlier, approximately 3.6 billion years ago, when Mars had widespread volcanic activity. Also this week, while exploring an underwater mountain located 300 kilometers off the shore of California and 3,070 meters deep, a team of scientists has discovered an ancient mammoth tusk. The tusk was first spotted during an expedition in 2019, but the team was only able to collect a small piece at the time. The team returned in July 2021 to collect the complete specimen. The researchers from University of California, Santa Cruz have confirmed that the tusk, about 1 meter in length, is from a Colombian mammoth. The cold, high-pressure environment of the deep sea uniquely preserved the tusk, giving researchers the opportunity to study it in greater detail. CT scans of the specimen will reveal the full three-dimensional internal structure of the tusk and more information about the animal's history, such as its age. The team believes that this could be the oldest well-preserved mammoth tusk recovered from this region of North America. Dating of the tusk is still in progress, but researchers have already shown that the tusk is much more than 100,000 years old. This is Mona Basu, special correspondent at The Print. If you like our videos, do consider paying for a subscription to The Print. You can do so through the link in the description box below.